Hello, my name is Sarah Walker. I am a lead guide at Base Camp Colorway, and today we are here to talk about whitewater safety. When it comes to being in a swift water environment, some of the hazards include the water itself. The water here, depending on the river, can be pretty cold, from 50 to 60 degrees. And when an individual is in an unfamiliar environment, panic can quickly set in. Going after that person ourselves can be very dangerous, because at that point they are using their survival instincts, and they might see you as a rescuer as a piece of flotation rather than safety. This is why we recommend a swift water rescue training certificate before you attempt such advanced techniques, because there have been cases where rescuers have drowned trying to save an individual in need of help. On many rafting trips, it's usually an enjoyable and fun occasion, but sometimes the situation can go a little awry, and you might want to know these tips for ensuring that everyone remains safe and happy. If someone is in distress and is in need of rescue, always keep in mind the following sayings: reach, throw, row, and go. Reaching out can be with your voice, or with a paddle. Throwing can involve throwing a rope bag device, paddling out to them if you have your own kayak or raft, and lastly, going after them yourself. Now, it's important to know that going is extremely dangerous, and you should not attempt this unless you have a swift water rescue training certificate. When we are using a swift water crossing with more than one individual, it's important to designate one person as the leader. If you're using the wedge formation with one individual in front, that person in front is the lead communicator.
Go!
You want to stay close to each other to prevent the water from flowing through and pushing you back. The most dangerous part of the river is the bottom of the river itself. The bottom is very rough and irregular, and there's a possibility of getting your foot caught. When that happens, the water can hold you under, creating a drowning risk. That is why we use the whitewater swimmer's position, with our nose up, toes up, feet pointing downstream, so that way we can keep our body off of most of the rocks, and if we were to hit a rock, we could bounce off it with our feet rather than our head. Other additional risk includes fallen trees, known as strainers. You can think of it as a pasta strainer, except that we are the noodles and the water is the current. If you get caught in that strainer, it's very difficult to get out. The best way to deal with them is to avoid them. If you see that strainer, swim away. Turn onto your belly and swim as hard as you can away from that obstacle to a point of safety. A good PFD fit should be nice and snug. You want to make sure that all the buckles have been adjusted and tightened. A good PFD fitting will not go above the ears when pulled up. It's important when someone's pulling you in that they're going to get you inside of the PFD rather than just the PFD. It's important to immerse yourself in this environment with the right training, the right background, and with the right crew. Never start swimming around these areas by yourself. You always want to have a buddy system, so if something were to happen, someone can help you out. Enjoy your next adventure in a swift water rescue environment, and don't forget to have fun.